Jordan Poole, Juan Toscano-Anderson, Emmanuel Villalitza, Gary Payton II, and Otto Porter Jr.
Pistons are switching everything, so someone just got to beat their man off a dribble.
Villalitza did just that and flipped it up and in.
That's what you need.
On it, but the fact that he's staying out is kind of good. Payton got on the deck, but Saban Lee tracked it down. Feed Magruder. He's on fire.
He's absolutely. Guys have their own ways of staying warm over there. Some guys, you'll see them have like a heat pack.
Try my new $6.99 spicy cluck sandwich combo. Order on the Jack app today.
I do think it's funny. Sometimes with young guys, it's like they're only looking to score. He's trying to do more than just that.
Pacers with That third one is tough. If you miss the first two, they used to have three to make two in the NBA. You don't want the hat trick. Villalitza with a step around.
Bangry.
Well, he's been called for five fouls in 10 minutes. He does not want to foul out in short stints. That's a nice finish by Saban Lee. It was pretty good defense. Just beat. It's the Rodney Magruder.
It's the Rodney Magruder show.
Now, Magruder is a 23%. Get Klay Thompson back. You know what is the next thing?
James Wiseman.
But after Wiseman, Klay is fouled. I'm aching for Draymond, Steph, and Klay.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, I just, you know, that's the thing with Draymond's calf injury is just Draymond was so excited to be out there with the two Splash Brothers. Getting the three of them together is going to be amazing. We'll find out what's coming up with Kareth and Mully and Darrell Wright on Warrior Post Game Live.
I'm Kareth Burke via WebEx from Cisco. Jonathan Kuminga, huge opportunity for him to start tonight, his third start of the season. We will break down his game and hear all of the postgame comments from tonight's stars. Now back to Fitz and Buki.
I think Kuminga tonight, I'm looking at the 9 rebounds in 19 minutes. You know, it's not all points. He cut nicely, and Steph found him for one of the buckets. He's, you know, had a couple early fouls, but has played pretty quality defense. Just, when you're 19, you're just watching how these kids grow kind of game by game.
Well, he's one of those players. He has to realize he can impact the game, not just with scoring.
Oh, my God!
Booty will pick up the foul.
If you're that athletic, you have to use it on the boards, too.
When does that mindset change for a young player where points, or then, wait a minute, there's other things I need to do to help the team win?
It's different for different players. Some guys come into the league and they just have that extra level of maturity and just understand there's so much more to the game than just the scoring, and they can use their athleticism to their advantage on the boards. And other guys get it a little later. And I think with this team and the leaders you have here, guys are in his ear. So that helps too. You get it sooner. Just understanding, hey, there's more to this game than you scoring. You're going to be able to make plays for others. You're going to be able to rebound offensively and defensively. You can be able to run the floor and put pressure on the defense. Just your speed cuts are going to open up the floor for others. Your unselfishness is going to be reciprocated. There's so much he can do out here just being on the floor.
Klay creating for Villalitza, missing that three. When I think of Detroit, though, I think of a guy where you never asked what his scoring average was in Dennis Rodman. Okay, the defense and rebounding, and he's in the Hall of Fame. And the reason why is because he was involved in winning. What can I do to help the team I'm with win?
He was just an expert on the boards. That's the main thing you focused on, that in defense. Talk about a guy like Ben Wallace as well.
He leads it, went to set up Moody, and Jackson with the foul, and then helps him up, which is nice.
I like how Bielitz has played since he's been hacking people on the other end. He's upset about it.
Well, Jackson's fouled out of the game in his own right. So 4:47 left. It's been a comfortable Warrior game. They're just looking to finish it off.
Where the concern has been as far as their shooting percentage goes. But again, this game, I saw it again. The intentionality when it comes to getting into the paint, breaking the paint in different ways. Throwing it in the post, drive it in there, just beat your man off the dribble or pick and rolls. They're doing it in so many different ways, and there's so many different options. It's really giving defenses a tough time.
And you think about Indiana Thursday and then Houston on Friday, but Utah's a quality defensive team. Dallas, Jason Kidd has them top five in defense. Minnesota's a top 10 defensive team. And then you have Brooklyn. So your offense better be clicking because it's going to be challenged. That was a weak side block of epic proportion. You can have the foul down low, but Jonathan Kuminga, he had people oohing and aahing in the building.
That's another place he can use his athleticism. On the defensive end, look at him on the weak side block. He just comes over at exactly the right time and fell over Juan Toscano-Anderson.
Wow.
That is elevation and timing.
This is a league of spectacular, wonderful players, and they do things. I think of the Ja Morant two-handed block and just things that take your breath away. The guys in the league are like, wow, Kuminga, he does some stuff that is that raises some eyebrows.
Right? He's got a reputation to where if he's getting downhill and he has a chance to rise up, people think twice before they jump with that man.
Just can't get over that he'll be 20 next October. He is young at 19. And learning in the best league in the world. One of the best teams in that league. Kuminga spinning and finishing.
He's got post game two now. Back to the basket. That looked comfortable. Just spun right off of his body.
Good defense by JTA. And here he goes. Let the young